others will love banks. Great, you and I love my share. Have you all seen the movie Bridge on the River Kwai? Those who haven't seen it, please see it. What I'm going to tell you shortly is literally all these elements together. And last question. Jungle biking, anybody? Wildlife trackers? Great. I have something for you also. What I tell you today is a story which my grandfather told me. He was an army man. He started duty World War II and finished in 1971. So he's been there through. And when he started World War II, he started on the place where I'm going to tell you the story of what happened. And incidentally, when he finished the war in 1945, the war for the British in Burma finished at the same place where this war started, literally. My grandfather finished with a Burma Star when he finished service from the British Indian Army. So, the actual story goes something like this. This is what he told me. I had to cross-check with Wikipedia, etc. And my uncle, who's also ex-army, to put things together into perspective. February 1942, Burma. A few months, about 2 months, 3 months earlier, Japan had flattened Pearl Harbor. And now the Japanese fleet and their forces, all their armies, were sweeping across Asia. Thailand, Cambodia, Singapore, Malaysia, just wiped off the map. That was the force of the Japanese armies when they let loose. Now, in this juncture, remember we are talking of pre-independent India, Burma was property of our dear Queen Mother, and she had no ideas whatsoever to let it loose, to give it to the Japanese under any circumstance. The British knew that very well, and they sent in their forces to ensure defenses were happening. We had the 17th Indian Infantry, which was in eastern Burma, and they were holding fort and they were taking a beating at the Battle of Bilin River. This happened a few days before this actual battle, which happened at a place called Sitang, which is in Burma. And the Battle of Sitang is what I'm telling you about. What happened here was, the 17th Infantry took a severe pounding and a thrashing from the Japanese forces. This was just one huge regiment against several armies. We're not talking of a regiment of the Japanese forces. We are talking of several armies coming in over there. We had the 214th and the 215th armies of the Japanese forces which was being engaged over there. This infantry had taken severe punishment and these men were somehow trying to get away. On the 19th and the 20th night of February, these guys disengaged from the Japanese forces and they hiked 30 miles. This is why I asked you how many of you carried your bags to school. They hiked 30 miles with armor, guns, your luggage, all the stuff. Colonel sir, you know what I'm talking. I don't have to explain. What happened was these men were all beaten hard and they had to cross the Sitang River Bridge into safety, into India. And the British force there was commanded by Brigadier John Smith. He later had a Victoria Cross awarded to him for his bravery, etc. And he set up his troops on the eastern bank and on the western bank of the river bridge. The eastern bank, there's a place called Pagoda Hill, which exists even today. And the major force was kept over there, while Brigadier Smith was on the western bank. He was away from the bank, actually. He was not there physically present. He had his forces over there. The night of 21st, 22nd, when these forces approached the Sitang Bridge path, the Japs were waiting. Two armies were waiting. So there was a night battle of sorts happening over there. One stage passed, these guys waited, they hid away in a rubber plantation called the Bogyari Estate, and they waited over there for dawn. these guys finally decided to take a make. It was a make or break choice. You have the bridge in front, freedom, safety, versus getting butchered over here. These guys were low on ration, low on water. They decided to take their chances early morning. They made a break towards the bridge, and all hell started. The armies of the Japanese forces came in, and they were supported by the Japanese Zeros. Zeros were the nickname given by the British forces for the Mitsubishi A6M long-range fighter bombers. These are very fast and lethal, and they were naval-based peacekeeper if needed to be. So they could come from land or they could come from sea. So the air assault on one side, the ground assault on the other side. So these guys took it up. The forces on Pagoda Hill also engaged, and more than 30 hours of battle went on. Now we're talking of 30 hours of not just hiding behind a rock and firing at the enemy. We finally boiled down to hand-to-hand combat, like how Arun sir said in the trenches. Hand-to-hand combat, ladies and gentlemen. That's why I said, if you remember the fights you had on the ground and getting bruised, it's exactly where I'm referring. Only thing this time is even far more deadly. You either walk away alive or you go. Many of our men took this battle down to that level. Guns empty, bayonets run. That's all. Bayonets go hand to hand. After that, you're alive? Great. My grandfather was also there in this battle as a young man of just 19. Battle moved on. They somehow things kind of settled down towards the early night. And towards early next day morning, Brigadier Smith decided that it was too dangerous to not trust the bridge being kept and saved for our forces, and he decided that it was better to take a call and blow the bridge. Now, this is a very dangerous issue. Reason being, Smith was not aware that two things were happening over there. One, the pagoda guys at the Pagoda Hill were holding the fort, and the other, the headquarters at a place called Kyakto, which was a little further away, again the Indian forces were holding the fort. Brigadier Smith didn't know these two events, but he still decided that the bridge had to go. If you see this map over here, you are seeing the march which our forces took from there, and this is the actual land map of Kohima, and this map is what I want to show you guys. If you see the way it is going, you can see the dark mark arrows, which is the Japanese advance, and how the Indian forces in the dotted arrow. This is a map which I wanted to show you. This is how the battle also finished. And today, you mean, this is a picture which Arun sir and similarly as others be. This particular portrait, it was drawn by an art historian, an army historian of sorts. He painted this picture of the actual explosion. What happened was, Smith gave the order for blowing the bridge. Imagine Diwali running loose, big time. Literally, that's what happened. So when the bridge was blown, 5 minutes there was pin drop silence. Nobody knew what was happening. And all hell broke loose after that. Those who wanted to save themselves jumped into the water, tried to swim as much as possible. And most of those guys, somehow managed, but still a force of more than 6,000 were there on the wrong side of the road, on the eastern side of the bridge. But luckily the Japanese army decided that they had enough. Instead of murdering these people who were almost defeated and finished, they decided to find a shorter route to cross. And that is how the Battle of Sitang River ended in a disaster for Japan. In India, sorry. But the same bridge, the same place, 1945. My grandfather was there once again. This time, the commanding officer who surrendered to him gave him his samurai sword as a mark of surrender. We had it in our home, and today it sits in the regimental museum in his 16th cavalry. Thank you.